Have you ever wished you could automate something in your house, like making the lights turn on automatically when you enter a room, or creating a little device that waters your plants when the soil gets dry? Well, the tool that can make all of that possible, and much more, is called Arduino. Welcome to the first lesson of a brand new series called Arduino for Beginners. My name is Lucas and I'll be your teacher throughout this exciting journey where you'll learn how to bring electronics and programming together to create real-world projects. This course was designed especially for beginners, people who are just starting out with Arduino or electronics. But if you're a bit more experienced, you will still find value here since we'll cover a wide range of topics and hands-on projects. We have 24 classes divided into 5 modules, and each module builds on what we learned in the previous one. So by the end, we will have a complete understanding of Arduino, not just the theory, but how to actually use it to build your own projects. You can follow the lessons in order, or if you prefer, you can jump directly to the topics you are interested in. Either way, you'll find extra materials like articles, scripts, and resources linked in the video descriptions. And don't worry, everything is free. I'll try to keep these lessons as clear and friendly as possible, just like a conversation between you and me. And if I mention a technical term you don't know, feel free to pause the video and look it up. That's part of the learning process. Alright, so let's tackle the big question for today. Why should you learn Arduino? Well, Arduino is an open source ecosystem of hardware and software tools designed to help makers, students, and engineers create projects that interact with the real world. That might sound like a mouthful, so let's break it down. When I say ecosystem of tools, I mean a set of things that work together. At the heart of Arduino is a programmable board, a small piece of hardware you can connect to sensors, motors, LEDs, and other components. But Arduino is not just the board, it also includes software you use to program it, like the Arduino IDE. The Arduino IDE is a program you install on your computer that lets you write code and send it to your Arduino board. It's super beginner friendly and made to be as simple as possible, so even if you never coded before, you can start creating projects quickly. And on top of that, we have Mind Plus, another beginner friendly software that works with Arduino. It uses a block-based visual interface, kind of puzzle pieces, to make programming easier for people just starting out. You can also switch to text-based coding when you are ready to level up, making it a perfect learning companion. So, what kinds of problems can you solve with Arduino? Let's imagine a few. You can connect a soil moisture sensor and a small water pump to automatically water your plants when they need it. You can use a motion sensor to turn on a light when someone enters a room. You can display the current temperature and humidity on an LCD screen and keep it updated all the time. Or even build a simple alarm system, a smart home model, or a weather station right from your desk. Arduino makes this kind of projects accessible and fun, and the best part is, you don't need to be an engineer or professional programmer to get started. Originally, Arduino was created to help students learn electronics and coding, but it grew so fast that today it's used by hobbyists, engineers, and even companies for prototyping and testing ideas. There are even advanced boards like the Arduino Opta, made for industrial projects, though we won't get into that in this course. Here, we'll focus on learning the fundamentals and building practical, beginner-friendly projects. For this course, I'll be using the Mind Plus Arduino Coding Kit, which was kindly provided by DF Robot, the awesome sponsor of this course. If you've never heard of them, DF Robot is one of the most popular online stores for makers, students, hobbyists, and even professionals. They sell everything from Arduino boards, sensors and robotics to industrial electronics and STEAM education tools. Whether you're just getting started or you're already building complex projects, they've got something for you. I generally recommend checking out their website, not only because they support content like these, but because they offer high quality, affordable projects and a huge selection of kits just like the one I'm using here. If you are looking to start your own project or follow along with this course, You'll find everything you need right there. Now, speaking of kits, this Mind Plus Arduino Coder Kit is amazing because it comes with 18 sensors and modules plus all the accessories you need to follow along with the lessons. It's perfect for people who want to get started and keep going without having to search for extra parts. We'll cover every single component in this kit throughout the course, so by the time you finish, you'll know exactly how to use them in your own project. If you want to get the most out of this course, I highly recommend picking up one of these kits. It will make following along much easier and give you everything you need to start building your project. A huge thank you to the App Robot for sponsoring this course. I really appreciate the support and making this series possible. So let's recap. In this first lesson, we introduced the Arduino ecosystem and explained why it's such a valuable tool for makers, students, and engineers. We talked about how it combines hardware and software like the Arduino IDE and Mind Plus. We also went through how this course is organized into 5 modules and 24 lessons, each building on the last, with hands-on projects and extra learning resources available for free in the video descriptions. I hope this introduction got you excited because we are just getting started. In the next lesson, we'll dive into the story of Arduino and look at some real-world applications that people have already built with it. Thank you so much for watching. If you are ready to start creating amazing things, I'll see you in lesson 2, coming very, very soon.